Now for something completely different, a plan by leading scientists, including Professor Stephen Hawking, to send a spacecraft to another solar system. And it is as ambitious as it sounds. The ship would need to travel trillions or thousands of billions of kilometers, much further than any craft ever before. And the plan is to develop a craft about the size of a microchip that could travel at exceptional speed. Pallab Ghosh has been looking at whether such an impossible sounding mission could be possible.
For thousands of years, people have dreamt of one day travelling to distant stars. The world's most famous scientist, Stephen Hawking, thinks that that day will come very soon.
Astronomers believe there is a reasonable chance of an Earth-like planet orbiting one of the stars in the Alpha Centauri system. But we will know more in the next two decades. From ground-based and space-based telescopes, technological developments in the last two decades and in the future make it, in principle, possible within a generation.
Already, a probe has been sent to Pluto. That's 7.5 billion miles away. And Voyager 1 has reached the edge of our solar system. That's 18 billion miles away. The plan is to send a spacecraft to a star in another solar system. That's a staggering 25 trillion miles away. Using current technology, it would take a spacecraft 30,000 years to get to our closest star. But by making them smaller, it could take just 30. They used to be the size of trucks and large cars. Over the years, the size of spacecraft have shrunk dramatically. In the 1980s, this microsatellite was used for Earth observation. In the 1990s, this nanosatellite was launched for communications. The ultimate aim of the new research program is to make them even smaller, to cram all the cameras and instruments you have in these onto a single chip. The idea is to launch these mini spacecraft into the Earth's orbit. Each would have a solar sail. A giant laser on Earth would give each one a powerful push, sending it on its way, reaching a speed of 100 million miles per second.
There are no greater heights to aspire to than the stars. It is unwise to keep all our eggs in one fragile basket. Life on Earth faces dangers from astronomical events, like asteroids or supernovas, and other dangers from ourselves. If we are to survive as a species, we must ultimately spread to the stars.
Here in Surrey, where they pioneered the development of mini-satellites 30 years ago, scientists believe it will be possible.
A lot of what we did back in the 1980s was considered very wacky, and now small satellites are all a fashion. This is currently a wacky sounding idea, but technologies have moved on, and now it's not just wacky, it's just difficult.
There's still a lot of work needed to develop the technology, but scientists believe that although it'll be difficult, it won't be impossible. What was once a distant dream could very soon become reality. Pallab Ghosh, BBC News.
He was a musical innovator who revolutionised the world of jazz. Now the life